pick your class and
earn your battle points.
Because it's time for the Star Wars Battlefront Podcast. Welcome to episode 181 of the Star Wars Battlefront Podcast. I'm your host, Sage Goodwin, joined by my brother and co-host, Sam Goodwin.
Hello there.
In this episode of the podcast, we'll be going over the recent details regarding the hero changes coming up on the next update, as well as the details we've got on that update.
Let's get started.
So you know how in The Last Jedi...
The Last Jedi?
The Last Jedi is the 8th Star Wars movie. Did you not know that? So, The Force Awakens. The whole plot is finding Luke Skywalker, the Last Jedi, who's gone into hiding. And then The Last Jedi, they find him.
Swolling. There's finding, swolling, swole. Swelling.
But where I'm going here is that the developers went on to a island planet to go disappear for a little bit. But now they're back. And we have a lot of stuff on Twitter because of that. How'd you like that little story there, Sam? That little trip across the galaxy to get to the point I was making.
Pretty painful.
But we do have a lot of tweets and content and teases and confirmation from the developers. Let's start off with Guillaume Meraz. Big Guillaume says, haven't been around for a while. Vacation and finishing up little droids. Hope you like BB-8 and BB-9E. They were fun to make, and I hope it shows. Probably in my favorite three heroes in terms of development with Greedo and Grievous. As our general said, never underestimate a droid. So that's pretty cool. I'm glad that they're back and are on Twitter and are confirming these things. Are you excited for BB-8 and BB-9E?
Definitely. I'm interested to see how it plays in the game. We've had droids in the past, but it wasn't really controllable. Mm-hmm. Like, to this degree, that's going to be interested to see how that plays out and if they can contest with the other heroes, because they are droids, but like you said, never underestimate a droid. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to be interested to see how that plays out.
Yeah.
You could play, like Hero Showdown with BB-8 and Finn. That'd be cool. Yeah, I'm just really interested to see how it works out. Because when you compare Darth Vader to a BB-8 droid, it doesn't really seem like that's a fair fight.
Who's going to win there?
And how do you force choke a droid? That's probably going to happen. This tiny sphere is going to be floating in the air, choking.
It's just going to start crumpling
up. It's like an Apex where Pathfinder is affected by caustic gas when he doesn't have a respiratory system.
He's just playing along with all the other people. He needs to fit it, obviously. That's how that works. I love the memes on that. Yeah, I'm super excited to see how BB-8 and BB-9E play. It's going to be, like you said, it's going to be so funny to watch them and play them up against big heroes. Like BB-8 versus Darth Vader, BB-8 versus General Grievous, BB-9E versus Luke versus Chewbacca.
Yeah, that's going to be really weird. I don't know. It's just going to be strange to see. I don't see how they're going to be able to match, but I mean, the hitbox is going to be crazy because mm-hmm. if you think Yoda's small, this is probably going to be just a tad bit smaller. And I'd imagine they'd be pretty speedy too, so.
I think at least canonically, BB-8's like 0.1 meters taller than the Yoda.
Seriously?
I think so.
Yeah, but I'm interested to see how speed's going to be an effect. And Yoda has a weird hitbox already, so.
Yeah.
That's going to be a factor for sure, which is probably going to play to his advantage, which means probably have less health and get away with it because mm-hmm. it'll be harder to hit.
Yeah, I was just about to ask, how much health do you think that they're going to have?
Let's see. Maxed out Vader has, 1,000?
Yeah, something like that. 1,000, yeah, 1,100.
Yeah, I could see him being 4 or 5.
Mm-hmm. What is it? Yoda?
Maybe 600.
Yoda's 4? 400? 400
I think he's
or 5?
A little more than that. I'm not 100% sure.
Maybe 450?
Something like that. I could see him being 4 or 5.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because it's not really feasible to make him... Unless he's super speedy and hard to hit, you shouldn't have any hero under 400 health.
Yeah.
Because that's where you're getting into the terrain of it's a trooper, because troopers have 200 health.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and like reinforcements have...
I think they have 350,
yeah,
sometimes.
Most of them have like 350, a little more, a little less for some.
Yeah, I think some have 250. Yeah, but I think the 200 is from the heavy, which is a little tankier than the normal like officer or assault.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm interested to see how, like I said, the speed and the hitboxes play into his health. I mean,
Also, mobility will be an interesting thing. Will they be able to jump?
I don't know.
Stars Battlefront podcast asking the hard-hitting questions here.
I could see him playing a little bit like the Wrecking Ball in Overwatch. Like, he's spherical. I mean, he has like a he's really speedy. He's got a grappling hook. I could see maybe a grappling hook coming into play to boost his speed up, maybe grappling to a wall to pick up a little more momentum and maybe even swing and to hit someone with it. I don't know. We've obviously seen BB-8 be aggressive in the films with mainly The Last Jedi.
Yeah.
But he's got a lighter. He's got a lighter, so yeah. We could see fire coming, maybe a flamethrower type thing. Yeah, but BB-9E, that's basically like just the evil version.
Yeah.
So I'd assume...
He's very good at telling other people that BB-8's around.
Yeah, but I like when they don't have any like aggression to base off of, like already established abilities. So we get something new and surprising. Mm-hmm. So I think BB-9E is going to be like a wild card and
yeah,
have some cool stuff we haven't seen.
I can't remember who, but it was someone on Twitter made a great point that I fully agree with. Nyan Num was a hero we knew nothing about. Most people knew nothing about. But he was an unknown character mostly. He was mentioned through the books, mentioned and barely seen in the movies. So they got to really play around with what they can do as far as abilities go, as far as playstyle and all of that.
And there was other instances of that Dengar. I mean, he was explored in the Clone Wars a bit,
yeah,
some other canon, but even Greedo, like, they weren't really fleshed out as much as some other characters.
Nyan Num, Greedo, Bosk, for the most part.
Bosk was in the show for a little bit, but...
And then we've got, what did I say, Dengar?
I don't think so. Yeah, I mentioned Dengar earlier, but...
Yeah. Yeah, we had a wide selection of heroes in Battlefront 2015 that nobody really wanted, but turned out to be fan favorites. Like, Nyan Num was my favorite character to play in Battlefront 2015.
I mean, it's not that we didn't want them. It was just really unexpected. It's not, like, on our priority list, even on our list at all.
Mm-hmm. A surprise, to be sure, but a welcome one.
But yeah, so these characters that we don't really have much to go off of usually end up being very interesting. Like, we've got reinforcements like that, too. The commando droid, or the commando trooper, as well as the B9 commander droid.
And that's why I was fairly disappointed with the array of the prequel era heroes and villains we got. Because those were, I mean, they're like must-haves, I guess. But I would much rather have had, like, a Cad Bane type or a lesser-known Clone Wars character like we did see Greedo or Bosk or Dengar being added. I mean, obviously, you kind of need General Grievous and...
I think if they had gone the mysterious person route, people would have had a riot. But yeah, I'm with you on that. I think it would have been very great to see that unknown or lesser-known character that we only see, like, in the Clone Wars show. Mostly we got Clone Wars in terms of the movies and not the show content.
Yeah, I mean, like we said, I mean, it's kind of a must. You have to add General Grievous. I mean, Count Dooku's a must.
You can't not add
Obi-Wan
Anakin.
Is a must. So all of those were pretty, you know, staple in the prequel era. But, I mean, this comes again to where there's so much content in the prequel era that I'm just feeling like they're missing out on so much. And they seem to, like, just be in the midst of the prequel era for so long.
Yeah.
Like, it seemed like the longest season we had.
It was definitely the longest season we had.
Yeah, it seemed like a long time, but we didn't get as much content as I would have liked. So, but I'm glad they're adding BB-8 and BB-90 just because of the fact that I would not have expected them to add. I mean, I could see him adding it as a reinforcement.
Yeah.
But not as like a staple hero. So
it's really good to see.
Interested to see.
Glad that they're doing something new for the game. And I think it's going to be fun. Another tweet regarding some of the nerfs in the game. Guillaume goes on and says, Anakin and Palpatine will see some nerfs in the January patch. Anakin around his star cards and damaged troopers mostly. Palpatine, his chain lightning range, dark aura, slow is removed, and slight main lightning damage reduction. After January, I will be focused on more balances and fixes.
Palpatine can be overpowered in like a team setting.
Yeah.
Like, as long as he has like a couple companions, he can take down some health for sure.
Even a... Even AI Palpatine is pretty overpowered when he gets the chain lightning in co-op. And then Azatru replied to that, any update on Leia being tweaked? And Yam says, yes, needed a bit of code support for her update. I'm aiming at February, but could be March. The general will get her deserved update. Phasma's staff is also being worked on, and I want to fix all the hero scopes as soon as we have a window for it.
Yeah, that definitely needs some work as far as Phasma, even though scoping's kind of weird, like you mentioned. Phasma's staff has been whack since she was added. Like, that is a useless ability. Like, the range on that is ridiculous. Even, like, any sort of staff abilities in this, these games seem to be a little weaker.
Yeah.
Jyn Erso's was wonky. Even, which is the KFX spy that has the...
Yep.
And his is kind of underpowered, to be honest.
Yeah, barely use it. He also, Espen X Gaming on Twitter asks, anything on Boba? And Guillaume says, not for now, and asks what he would want to see happen. So I think it's good that they're not touching Boba, because I know a lot of people have issues with Boba Fett and don't want any more jetpack heroes, because in Heroes vs. Villains, all he has to do is fly away to a spot no one...
Yeah, that is annoying. He can just time you out. If you're, like, in a 1v1 situation, yeah, he can just time you out, which is stupid. Yeah, they just need to kind of block off the maps a little better.
Mm-hmm. Also, this is going to be cool. Oh, yeah. Forgot to talk about Vader's choke. Our animators have been busy, busy little bees. Buzz, buzz. And then Espen X Gaming again says, please tell me he can block while force choking like that scene in Rogue One. Guillaume responds with that scene in GIF form. And then Hamerica, Hammer the Senate, says, I will take that as a yes.
Yeah, he's a little vulnerable when he force chokes. So that would be, that's just really cool to see.
Yeah.
That would just, the animation would be awesome.
Mm-hmm. So it's, I think that's going to be happening to to Darth Vader, which I'm really excited about. I think that's going to look awesome. And then he goes on, plan for Leia is buff one ability, modify one ability, and then completely change one ability. Not set yet, but that's the current goal.
She's a little underpowered, I will say.
Mm-hmm.
She was a lot better in Battlefront 2015. When she could actually shoot through her shield.
I greatly enjoyed Leia's game. I think it was when Leia first came out and then before the DLC, that was my favorite character to play. I really, really enjoyed the gameplay for Leia. And then the final details that we've got for the update coming in January this month is when... Ben Walk says, next week's Star Wars Battlefront 2 update drops on January 30th. We're making some balance changes to Anakin and Palpatine. Auto players can now hit with melee attacks, and we fixed the issue that allowed them to shoot when they should be immobile. Droidica also gets a small buff. And we're also getting Capital Supremacy 2, the sequel trilogy, as well as Instant Action, which I'm super pumped about. Also, the AI characters in the co-op and... Capital Supremacy 2 and Instant Action will be able to melee attack once again. Yeah, so it's going to be a really fun update, and I think it's going to bring a lot of interesting content. I also like that Gia mentioned the future of the game a little bit, mentioning February and March possibly coming for the Leia update. So we will be getting support, it sounds like, through at least March. But I hope it continues to through the year, and we get a lot of good support for this game, because it's a growing game. Like we've mentioned many times before, it's a very, very great success story, rising from the ashes, as well as a great game, just a good game in general that feels like it's just getting started. So that's always fun to see.
Yeah, because the graphics are still there. It's not like they need to rework any of the main things, so... Yeah, a bunch of stuff they can add still. They could just make this game for years and years with all the content Star Wars has. So
definitely. And like I said last week, I think the only way a next game would work, like if they did a Battlefront 3, would be to set it up to where it is a lengthy supported game, but it's like Battlefront Ultimate, to where they get it set up to where they can do whatever they want to. They're not limited by anything in the game like they are in this one, where the star cards are limiting how much they can add. The weapons are a little bit an issue of adding more. They just set it up to where it is a completely expandable and changeable game, and they add all of the stuff that was in Battlefront 2 and Battlefront 2015, as well as bringing in some of the content that a lot of the fans are wanting from all of the eras.
For sure, that's one of the complaints for Battlefront 2, is that we didn't have a bunch of the heroes or villains that we really liked in the previous game, and the maps. They did port the Jabba's Palace, mm-hmm. so that was nice to see, but still a bunch of different cool maps that I would have liked to see added to this game as well.
I would love a map season that adds a bunch of maps from Battlefront 2015, because hands down, they have some of the best maps in that game. The Hoth map is one of my favorite in any of the games, including the original ones. Like, that was my favorite to play, where it really felt like you were in the trenches.
For sure.
I don't get
Solus
that same.
Solus was a really cool map too.
Yeah. Yeah, I would love to have Solus back. Please, please bring Solus back. That was my favorite map. It was something that was mentioned throughout the movies, throughout the comics, throughout the books, mentioned through everything, and we got to see it fully imagined and playable. It's such an interesting map too, because it's where the Star Destroyers get made, and it has a color palette that is not seen in Battlefront 2.
Even I like Jakku, the map was really cool too. And that's another sand planet, but
yeah, it was a different map from what the Jakku that we've got in this one.
Yeah, a lot of these are variations of the maps. The Endor map is different. And I really like the original Endor map, too.
Mm-hmm. Really fun to play Heroes versus Villains on.
Oh, yeah.
Do we have... Can't remember. It's been a while since I've played an Endor. I've been playing Clone Wars and sequel trilogy content, like, 24/7 since the Clone Wars began. But in the Endor map, do we have the layered gameplay like we do in Battlefront 2015, where it's got the Ewok support structures and that kind of thing, where you can get up on there? I think so.
I've never really tried it.
It's been so long since I've played Endor. That lets me know I need to play Endor some more. It's been so long since I've played Galactic Assault.
For sure, Capital Supremacy is the big game mode to get my fix, and then smaller game modes would just be hero-based game modes for me.
Mm-hmm. Co-op has had my soul since it came out, man. I have been playing co-op pretty much every time I play Battlefront. I'll play some of the smaller game modes too, but usually I jump in for co-op and then play on the smaller game modes afterwards. News as far as Star Wars Battlefront podcast goes, we are working on the new studio. We're getting ready to get it soundproofed. And it's going to be awesome. We're also, I'm looking to get an Ethernet cable put in so we can have a hardwire connection and be able to stream content on our YouTube channel, which just surpassed 500 subscribers. So happy to hear that. We thank you so much for the support on there. We're looking to expand the content that we offer on the YouTube channel as well. Looking to do more gameplay, looking to do some streaming, looking to do some more like in-depth, shorter form videos like we did when we first started on the YouTube channel. Maybe some breakdowns, some collaborations with other YouTube channels. We've got some cool stuff planned, and we would really appreciate you giving us a follow there and supporting us even more. Our goal is to get to 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year. I'm pretty sure we can make it if we all work together and you subscribe and we bring the content. We can do at least 1,000, if not more. 2020 is going to be a fantastic year for Battlefront, for the Battlefront podcast, and all the stuff that we've got working on. I'm really excited to get to streaming. It's something that I've been wanting to do for a while. We tried it when Battlefront first came out, when Battlefront 2 first came out, we tried to stream it on the beta, but it just was not working. So we really want to try that again. I would also really like to be able to set up like a face cam too, and be able to do kind of like a more casual interaction with you, the viewer / listener, and be able to get some cool content going there and some back and forth discussion. This is a little bit of a shorter episode as we're heading right into the calm before the storm of the Battlefront January update. It's late as far as updates come, but that's understandable because most of the developers were on vacation and are just now getting back. So January 30th, we're getting the content for January, the finishing for the Rise of Skywalker update so far. I'm excited. Next episode, we'll be going over all the details, our thoughts on the content added, and just an overall viewpoint of the changes and our thoughts. Thank you so much for listening. I've been your host, Sage Goodwin.
And I'm Sam Goodwin.
You can follow us on Twitter at SWBpodcast, twitter.com/SWBpodcast. We've got 1,200 over 1,200 followers on Twitter. We would greatly appreciate having you. We're very active on there, posting content, posting thoughts, keeping news updated. We're very active there on terms of news. So we'd greatly appreciate a follow there. Another great place to follow us is on our Instagram and Facebook pages. Our Instagram is at SWB Podcast, the same as our Twitter, Instagram.com/SWB Podcast. And then it's just the Star Wars Battlefront Podcast on Facebook. We post memes. I made a meme, and you can see it on our Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram. But we post memes, we post clips of the show, we post, we're soon to be posting gameplay content on there as well. So definitely give us a follow there if you like Battlefront and Star Wars memes. You can support us on Patreon, patreon.com/Battlefront Podcast, like friend of the podcast, Joseph Loera, as well as through PayPal, paypal.me/tiedyesheep, TYEDYESHEEP, like friend of the podcast, Daniel Schilling. We're also heading to London, Dublin, and Inverness in March. We're planning a 2-week trip to go through all three of those cities, and we would love to meet up with you, or if you are in any of those or near those. We won't have a car, so it'll be difficult getting around unless it's like on the train system, but we would love to meet you up in any of those places and have a good time. Maybe go see a movie, go eat somewhere, have a good time in those places. We want to see all the sites. So if you're there, if you've been to those places, or if you're from those places, let us know what we can go check out.
Our Gmail is battlefrontpodcast@gmail.com, and also our YouTube channel is youtube.com/the Star Wars Battlefront Podcast.
Goal is 1,000. We can do it. Another way you can support us is through leaving a review on iTunes. It's a completely free way to support the show. We'd greatly appreciate it. It helps other listeners know what's going on with the show, as well as lets us know your thoughts and feedback. You can listen to the show on iTunes, SoundCloud, Stitcher, Google Play, Apple Podcasts, YouTube. Wherever you find podcasts, you can find this show. As always,
thanks for listening,
and may the Force be with you. It's the Star Wars Battlefront Podcast. Welcome. Welcome. Hey, Sam, how's it going? Hello, welcome. This is the Star Wars Battlefront Podcast. Thank you for listening.